Here's Letang dropping it back. And Letang was hit again. His helmet popped off. There's a penalty upcoming on the Rangers. Delayed penalty. Or pick to Letang. Penguins will get a power play. Letestu to Malkin. Saved by Lundqvist. And he's got the puck.
This is against Callahan. Now this happened away from the hit. Callahan was coming back down the middle of the ice when both he went down with one of the Pittsburgh players. That's always with Crosby here. Oh yeah. Oh, you know what? He's got a call. It should have been on Crosby. Crosby Slewfoots him. I mean, that should not only be a penalty on Crosby, but that's a Slewfoot in the league. You know, that's just dangerous play. Oh boy. I mean, that one was totally missed. You watch the right leg of Crosby. Kicks the feet out from Callahan, and Callahan gets called for interference.
Yep. Oh boy.
You know, remember last time these two teams played? Pittsburgh had 6 power plays. The Rangers didn't have one. Not one.
Callahan interference at 15 minutes. Standing.
And this was earlier. What a hit by Staal. That was happening right at the time that Callahan was being penalized.
Mike, on the penalty to Ryan Callahan, it looked like we saw a Slewfoot from Sidney Crosby. Did the bench see it? Did you guys have a reaction?
Well, that's what it looked like to us as well. But that's not how the referee saw it. We have to live with it and move on.
How difficult is that going to be during the course of the game?
Well, I don't think it's difficult. We have to play hockey, and the referees are going to ref, and they're going to see what they're going to see, and we can't worry about that. We got to play the way that we can and the style of play that gives us the best chance to be successful.
Thanks, as always.
Sure.
Assistant coach Mike Sullivan joining us on the Delta Intermission Report. When we come back, Al Trawig in studio with Brandon Dubinsky.
Take it away, Al.
All right, Sam. So what did you think of a very physical, very intense first period?
Yeah, it was good. I thought, we played the way we wanted to. Obviously, we had a tough bouncer in our zone, but, we got to make sure we keep pucks in their zone and keep crashing the net, and we'll get a couple.
We're going to show you a play that resulted in the whistle against Ryan Callahan. Get a good look at it and tell us what you think. I mean, it's pretty obvious here to us that it's a slew foot on number 87.
Right? Yeah, I mean, that's just a dirty play. That's the type of guy he is, away from when he tries to get away with all that kind of nonsense and complains a lot. But, we just got to fight through it and, just keep playing him hard and keep going.
You were able to generate some pretty good chances with the work behind the net.
Yeah, I mean, that's the strength of our team and, having obviously possession of the puck more than they do. And like I said, if we keep generating a forecheck like that, we'll create chances and find a few in the net.
Brandon, there was some talk on the 3-game road trip that the team was maybe feeling a little tired or a little fatigued. It certainly didn't look like that in the first period. Is that a wrong thought, or is it just that the team got their legs going again tonight?
Yeah, I mean, we had a good day yesterday to regroup. Guys got their rest, and, we had a good skate this morning. So, we prepared, all summer long and throughout the beginning of the year for a tough month here, and we got to make sure we finish off on the right note. And with the start we've had, we just got to keep generating, and we'll find a way to get done tonight too.
All right, he's the reason we always get great ratings in Alaska. Brandon Dubinsky here in the first intermission. We'll take a break on the Delta Intermission Report. Soon we'll hear the analysis of Brian Leetch in between periods 1 and 2.
If I was the Rangers players, I'd be disappointed maybe with the Crosby incident and being down 1-0, but their overall play was excellent.
Let's talk about the Crosby incident, what your view of the Slewfoot is and how bad it is in hockey and how dirty is a play it.
Well, I think before the focus on headshots and hitting from behind or into play, the big thing the league was trying to get rid of was the Slewfoot. It was creating dangerous time. People were separating their shoulders, being hit from, having their legs kicked out and falling on their back. They're injuring their knees. And this is, like Brandon Dubinsky said, it's a dirty play. I don't see Sidney Crosby do it a lot. Obviously, there's a lot of tension. Dubinsky's out there a lot against Crosby. But it's a play that the NHL has tried to get rid of, and it is a dirty play.
Okay, well, I'm just a fan. I see something like that, and you wonder, is Sidney Crosby getting away with one because he's Sidney Crosby? Or not. We're heading toward the second period. Pittsburgh has the lead 1-0 on the Delta Intermission Report.
The first one was against Crosby. It wasn't there. That was a hit on the offensive zone. And as they come up here, and I watch right there, is where Crosby takes the penalty, and then right after that, as where Frost was involved in front of the net. So they call it. We'll see 4-on-4 hockey.
Well, I think he makes a couple points there. First, he categorizes the Slewfoot as a dirty play, and he is absolutely correct. Sidney Crosby got away with a Slewfoot on Ryan Callahan here, trying to fight up the ice. Ryan Callahan skating with him. Sidney Crosby kicks his skate out. That's a Slewfoot. That's the definition of it. It's a very dangerous play. A lot of broken ankles can happen because of that. And then later in the game, Sean Avery, who is a bit of a dirty player in his own right, gets another one from Sidney Crosby. So definitely guilty of two Slewfoot incidents. But to call him a dirty player, I don't think that's fair. He plays very hard. He plays on the edge. He plays aggressively. He battles for his space. Sometimes he goes over the line, but I don't think it's with the intent of being dirty to injure. And I think that's one of the distinguishing characteristics of a dirty player is the intent. And I don't think he has that. And let's be honest, he takes a lot of abuse out there on the ice too. He's the recipient of a ton of dirty plays against because he is around the puck so much, because he battles so hard. So he's not a dirty player, although he had a couple dirty plays tonight.